Greetings, programs. This is Rhetch, and welcome back to Samurai Warriors 4-2. Now it's time for the conquest of Odawara as we complete Wisdom and Grace. A land of peace is finally within reach. The two strategists head to Odawara Castle in an effort to realize the dreams of the people. So I think this might be the first time that we played Odawara as a 10-star difficulty. I may be incorrect in that, but it should be interesting to see how Takakage and Kanbei deal with this. Dominion at any cost. The Toyotomi forces had surrounded Odawara Castle, the last bastion of the Hojo clan. Takakage and Kanbei were also among the attacking forces. Overwhelming numbers, that is the Toyotomi way in this game. So Kanbei was trying to find a peaceful way to coexist, and it just did not work out. Now, if I recall correctly, I believe Takakage and Kanbei, they're not around for the war between the Western and Eastern armies, so both of them probably pass on. I don't know about historically, but I think in the game we don't actually deal with them again after Hideyoshi unites the land. But I think Kanbei did find a suitable replacement for Hanbei. Just a little bit more, I wouldn't say cerebral, because Hanbei was definitely cerebral, but a little more mellow, a little bit more reserved, there we go, than Hanbei was. And their job is to try and end the battle before it becomes a wholesale slaughter.
Takakage, Kanbei wa Shikoku Kyushu no ikusa de tadaina kou o ageta.
Huzzah! Those are the island conquerors right there. Meanwhile, Well, Takakage and Kanbei were able to take on this castle without any bloodshed. This would be a very boring stage. So chances are good there'll be something special that Takakage and or Kanbei can do during the battle that we haven't seen before. So let's see what exactly that is. And we're getting closer and closer. We are running out of story modes, guys. I think we only have 3 or 4 to go. But I think we have a good one coming up. Now, we're definitely taking both of them. Off camera, I went ahead and upgraded their weapons. We just have to do their skills as normal. And we don't have a whole lot of tomes, so this is going to be relatively quick. I want to see if there is... Well, we've got Collector. I want to see if we have access to Connoisseur. Hoarder. I don't really care that much about good mounts. So, Alrighty. Well, let's go ahead and grab the... Where are you at? Collector. Gotta get more of those strategy tomes. Well, we could probably... Oh, wow, that's 8. That is more strategy tomes than I am willing to spend, to tell you the truth. Let's go ahead and grab this one to unlock more fortitude. And... I think we actually might be good. Since this is their last hurrah, I think we can afford to not use all the tomes. We'll just take that one. Oh wow, cool. We learned Verity and Might, and we will call that good. And it looks so simple, so easy at this point. The Hojo put up a good fight, though. This is one of the big battles in the game series. Right up there with Sekigahara and Osaka Castle. So, what to do first? I guess we will head this way. Head into the middle. Because I know Kai and friends are definitely going to be showing up soon. Alright, first up is Yujinori Hojo. And we have to defeat him. That's done. 20 potential weapon out of it. Good deal. Let's grab... Standard Bearer to even out this area. Alright, cool. We've got one officer coming toward us, if he can follow us this way. And we just had a bunch of officers just show up. Looks like Kanbei is on the case. Let's deal with this guy. Oh, excuse me, this lady. And also, since we're dealing with the Hojo, that means Kotaro Fuma is going to make himself known. There goes Kai. Okay. Fire all the beams. Defeat Ujikuni Hojo and allies to prevent the allied officers from being defeated. So we gotta take care of the southern front here. And there's our level increase. Yeah, the more I've been playing him, the more I realize I like Kanbei's character, I love his model, I hate how he fights. It's just very slow and probably just unwieldy is probably the best way I can explain it. Alright guys, hi. Just for in the issue of time, since Fuma just showed up. Let's throw a fist down. Defeat Fuma. Well, that will be Takakage's pleasure, and someone missed the fist. Alright. Takakage is on the case, though. So, let's hustle. Man, that ninja is fast. It's just like out of the first G.I. Joe movie. Man, that ninja's fast! And I'm just gonna deal with him right now. Oh crap. Well, that's awkward. But we still have our attack. Our attack buff up. And he has set fire to the middle. There we go. That's another high potential weapon. Kanbei is already over here. Let's grab the stand. And I think you just showed up. Eh! Stop it. You keep that spear to yourself, sir. And the defensive ward fire has been extinguished, fortunately. Alright, that was one. Defeat Ujifusa and now Shige, which we did just take care of one. Let's head over here and head this guy off. Here comes the fire attack. I like the fact that I've kind of come to the conclusion. Ow, holy crap. That is not good. Here, guys. I have an ultimate, or not an ultimate, but a true Musou. There we are. That's better. And we do have one more person to deal with here. That's Ujitada Hojo. And we got our level up. So he's back to full. Okay. And that wasn't even a fight. Holy crap. He just cleaved through that guy. And he just left his high morale area, so he should be pretty easy to deal with. And if Kanbei's heading that way, he's heading north into the fortress itself to deal with Lady Hayakawa and friends. So I'm going to head this way with Takakage, since we're not under any kind of time limit. We're going to take this area. Oh, peasants just showed up. That's going to be a strain on Takakage's morale. That's one. Now. Oh, that's a barracks captain. What am I doing? Okay. There we go. I'll grab this weapon. Now, I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to switch over. And I am going to send Takakage this way, because I want to take a look at those peasant soldiers. Kanbei can hold the front here. And I really think that he is more Musou based, or he is so dependent on that special skill of summoning more orbs to increase his defensive power. Or his offensive power, rather. Alright, did he drop anything? Ah, there he is. All right, the keep is now open. Let's go in and say hello, folks. My question is, can I get you all to follow me? Because if so, hello, Lady Hayakawa. Did we get everyone? Oh, two. Okay. One of them ran back. Fist in the air. Ooh, Lady Hayakawa did not get hit. We still have elemental attack, though, so. And what a way to go. Okay, Takakage did not follow my orders. So we still have peasant soldiers all over the place. Which is unfortunate, but... oh well. Boomba's gonna show up again. We just have to send someone over there, like, quick. Where are you? Oh, there you are. The true Musu. That was overkill, but... it's okay. Alright, everyone is pretty much dead. Except for Papa Hojo. I would like to find out about these peasants, so. I am gonna head this way. It says that Takakage is struggling, but we know that is not really the case. Besides, Fuma may show up anytime now. Should we go ahead and get some food while we're here? Might as well. There we are. Now, where are these peasants? Because there's a ton of red over here, but they're not really doing anything. Hello, peasant. Do we need to kill you? Okay, I guess they're just there. All right. Gotta take on the lion. Do a little lion hunting. And we just Mufasa'd him. Takakage got a ton of good weapons. That was relatively easy. Actually, that wasn't relatively. That was a very fast battle. I thought there'd be a little bit more to it. But now we get to see the aftermath of the battle. Actually, would have ended that a lot sooner had I not gone looking for those peasants. Inherited ambition. Defeat the enemy troops in the... oh. Whoops. And there was one for Takakage. I bet it had to do with those peasants. Man. That's alright. 47,000. New special skills. Now, let's take a look at this. Swordsmith's Blade Wind. Earth, Fire, Death. We got a 1-1 Jade. Another White Cloud, and a Kohibari. That was a good haul in terms of gear. Now, let's see the aftermath here. He already sees.
Kobayakawa Takakage was 高影がいれば、この天下分け目の戦いは避けられたのに。
最後の助言、あれは的確だったね。
ま、助言は守られそうにないけど。
Oh wow, that's cool.
これで日の元に賢人はいなくなった。
おりますよ、あなたが。軍師官兵衛殿。
Because I remember we had that one, we can now select any character in Wisdom and Grace. Cool. I like the fact that we had that one battle in Samurai Warriors 4, which was Kanbei's retirement, where he came out of retirement and it was his last battle. So that was kind of cool to see his fallen friends watching over him. So that was Wisdom and Grace. Now it's time for Friends and Rivals. We get to see the other side of the coin in Naomasa through Toyohisa's eyes. So good deal. And yeah, we only have 4 story modes to go. So let's make them good ones. And we will start Friends and Rivals in the next episode, guys. I hope you've enjoyed it. If you liked the episode, go ahead and click like down below. Subscribe to the channel, leave a comment. That'd be a big help. And we'll see you next time. Later days, everyone.